gentlemen, please welcome your host for Vodafone London Fashion Weekend, Angela Scanlon.
Hello everybody and welcome to Vodafone London Fashion Weekend. How are you all doing this Sunday afternoon? Jolly, you've been having a few sneaky bubbles already? Good, I hope you've got a spot of shopping in there too. We have got a really exciting show for you, and you guys are the only crowd to see this particular show. Who's a fan of Maria Grazia Vogel? Yes, good. That's what you're here for, I'm hoping. She's a bit, pretty wonderful, and the collection that you guys are about to see in a couple of minutes is very, very exciting. A little bit of information about this wonderful, formidable designer. Maria is a self-taught designer, sewer, pattern maker, the whole nine yards. She's been making clothes since she was a teenager and did her first ever collection at age 14. Yes, I feel inadequate too, it's fine. She left school to go straight to the city to pursue a career in finance with the view to eventually financing her own label, which she did in 1991 at the age of 17. She has since done incredible, incredible collections. She has dressed Emma Thompson, she's dressed Victoria Beckham. She's actually arguably responsible for Victoria Beckham's foray into fashion. Does anybody remember back in the day when Victoria Beckham was Posh Spice and she took to the catwalk during London Fashion Week in a pair of silky little pink hot pants? Yes. Yes, it was a pretty epic and iconic moment, and that was Maria, one of her designs. She did a little flirty flamenco pink outfit as well, and it was kind of the start of her career as well. So she's kind of one of those people who kickstarts a lot of things. Emma Thompson as well. Who's a fan of Emma Thompson? She's such an amazing lady. She was here, obviously, over the course of the BAFTAs. Quite incredible. Maria makes clothes for women that make them feel fantastic and not just look fantastic. They're timeless, they're ageless, they're wearable, and it's all about a relaxed sophistication, which we absolutely love. Instead of following trends, the Maria Grazia Vogel lady is about, you know, unique pieces that sit within a capsule wardrobe that she can wear forever and ever and love and care for, and that become very personally attached to her, which I absolutely adore, and I think it's quite fabulous when we think and we have an emotional connection to our clothes. Claire Danes is also a fan, and Jessie J, who supports the label too. She has two stores, one in Singapore and one in the flagship store in Sloane Street. The collection that you guys are about to see, I've been perving on it backstage, and it's absolutely beautiful. Lots of very ethereal fabrics. Very spring summer, and I'm hoping that you guys are going to get excited about the season because it's kind of creeping up on us, so this will definitely get you in the mood for a little bit of sunshine. And I think there's no better person to talk us through this beautiful and unique collection than the designer herself. So I'm hoping that you'll get a bit loud and raucous and give us a nice rapturous round of applause for the wonderful and formidable Maria Grazia Vogel.
Hello.
Fabulous. Head to toe in your own label?
Well, of course.
Of course, representing. Talk us through, I guess, your journey. It's a pretty exciting one. I mean, this time 20 years ago, you were shown in the London Fashion Week schedule. There are not many designers who can manage to endure for that length of time.
I know. I'm an old woman now.
You're fabulous.
Yeah, no, it's, well, I started very young. I mean, to be honest, it's hard to put a start date on my career, really, because I started, goodness, when I was 8, and then started cutting and sewing when I was 12 years old.
So. What was the very first piece you made as an 8-year-old?
I didn't make when I was 8, I was sketching and making kind of sketchbooks. But when I was 12, the first thing I actually made was a pair of knickerbockers.
As you do?
As you do. So, but that was kind of like, well, it was the 80s, I guess, so.
You've left knickerbockers behind.
I've left knickerbockers behind.
Thankfully. And, you know, I guess you kind of approach design as an architect. Would that be correct?
Yeah, I've always had this fascination, and I guess that's where it started, age 12, 13, 14, with how clothes look on your body and how to sculpt and create something that's really flattering to a woman's body. So, for example, all our trousers, they have no seams at the side.
The magic trousers.
And that makes them incredible. incredibly flattering on the body. Just small details that actually maybe you don't notice when you see it walk down the runway, or you don't really notice on a hanger, but when you put it on your body, you really notice
the difference.
Yeah.
And part of that process is fitting those clothes on numerous different women and different body shapes, is that correct?
Absolutely. I don't have the belief, I sort of believe that women come in all different shapes and sizes, and actually even if you look at the models, they're all different shapes and sizes, even though their measurements say the same thing. So it's like, it's all about body shape and finding things to suit and flatter your own body, and it's amazing what you can do with cut and fit, actually.
Yeah, that's the thing, and you know, we hear cut on the bias, sounds like quite an old school thing. I mean, my mum would have always said, oh, it's cut on the bias, that's very good. But like, it is those kind of really, you know, age old, fantastic techniques that you include within your designs.
Yeah, it's bias cutting, draping, but also sometimes it's just engineering. You know,
so
of the trousers are cut on the bias, but it's accommodating the female body. Mm-hmm. And I think if you cut for a model's body, models are typically much younger. Mm-hmm. Cut for real women or real women's bodies, it just hangs and looks beautiful on a model. So,
if we were to get one piece of yours, is it the magic trousers?
Probably a great pair of the magic pants, mm-hmm. Yeah. Or one of the jumpsuits, they're also fantastic.
Yeah, actually jumpsuits are having a bit of a moment. Any of you guys sport a jumpsuit from time to time? They're looking slightly terrified.
Do you know what's great about a jumpsuit? It's perfect flat tie, parties, cocktails. I run about them in the day, mm-hmm. And then it takes you straight into the evening. It's the perfect kind of...
I mean, it's kind of like an updated version of the little black dress.
It is.
It feels so perfect. Who is the Maria Grazioli woman? Can you define her, or is that boring to have to do?
Well, it's, you know, typically not defined by age, actually, mm-hmm. But much more by attitude. Somebody who likes to sort of feel confident in herself. So it tends to attract quite a strong, confident woman, and somebody who likes to put things together in her own way, in her own style. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we make great pieces that just work in your wardrobe.
Okay, so they're the workhorses.
Yeah.
We like that, and actually, you know, when I was... Obviously, wearable is a word that you use quite often. And wearable, for me, when I first started in fashion, wearable was a term that was kind of seen as a dirty word in fashion for a while. But designers are moving back towards that. But you've always been there, and wearability has been key.
Yeah, and just things like, for example, this, all of the prints that I do on the satin, they're all washable in the machine.
Okay.
So there's an element of practicality goes with some of the pieces I do. I don't know, I love that. It just means I can take it on holiday, it folds up, it rolls up, it's easy to pack, and it's got an element of usefulness and practicality.
So it's like for a busy woman with a busy life who wants to look fabulous while being busy.
Yeah, and it's easy. Everything's relaxed and easy and has got an element of glamour about it, I suppose.
Fabulous. Let's talk about the collection that this lot are about to see right now. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely gorgeous. What's the inspiration? Where does that come from?
Well, when I was creating the spring collection, I was really, because I'm always inspired as a starting point by the woman, and this time there was a sense of naivety about that woman. So I was kind of visualising this kind of young girl, and that moment of youth where you're really actually not aware of your own beauty,
and
you sort of radiate this kind of gorgeousness, but you're not really aware of that. So I was kind of really feeling that woman, mm-hmm. And then it sort of turned into this whole theme about artists, and this young girl was an artist, and she's wandering through the hills of Provence, and you can see sort of inspiration in the prints, which I paint myself, as I paint all of the prints myself. There's a sort of paint splashes and swirls of ink, and there's definitely a kind of, you know, naive art feel about it, which I wanted to kind of capture that young artist.
And the palette is very romantic, kind of desaturated, really makes me want summer to come very quickly.
Well, it's things like plaster and putty, and again, referencing those very sort of aqua tint and rose tint, those sort of artist colours in a way.
Yeah, so absolutely beautiful. Print, obviously you do hand-painted, beautiful prints. Is that a key part of what the label focuses
on? I mean, it's become a bigger and bigger part of what I do. You know, essentially, because my work is all about engineering on the form, with cuts and with fit, the next layer for that, in a way, is painting in a 3D form. So all of the prints that I paint are actually engineered around the body. So when you look at the collection, when you see the show, if you look at the garments and the way they're painted, it could never be done as a piece of fabric. It has to be done as a garment. So you'll see swirls spiraling around the dress, and that's following the line of the dress, it's following the line of the cut. And you know, that's how I like to work. It's like 3D art in a way.
Yeah, it's absolutely stunning. You guys are in for a real treat. Can we get a massive round of applause and a thank you to the wonderful Maria?
Thank you.
Okay, you guys, sit tight, enjoy the show, feel free to get involved. You can get a little bit noisy if you so wish, and I'll be back after the show. Enjoy.
Da 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 da
The little Ansel is kind of cute too, isn't he? Did you enjoy that? Yeah, absolutely ethereal and romantic and making me wish that I was going on a long, faraway holiday in an exotic place. Yeah, maybe in June or something. Okay, a couple of thank yous before I set you free to do a bit of shopping and maybe have a little cheeky cup of tea maybe, or bubbles, whatever you're into on a Sunday evening. Thank you to Tony and Guy and Maybelline New York, who did a beautiful job of our girls' faces, right? Yeah, and hair, yeah. They've been working tirelessly since 7 o'clock this morning and are, yeah, still bringing it, so we're very grateful to them. Triumph Lingerie, who gave us all of the underwear. Yasmin Le Bon was in the house yesterday giving our girls a modelling masterclass, so I hope that they were suitably impressive with their struts. They've been practising that too. A special thank you to Vodafone, without whom none of this would be possible. But most of all, thank you to you guys. I hope you had a wonderful show. I hope you enjoyed it and are feeling inspired for spring summer. I've been Angela Scanlon and I'm very grateful to you guys for being here and being so jolly and happy on a Sunday afternoon. Thanks a mil. Bye-bye.